Hello, I'm Dani Tagen, culture and heritage photographer and consultant. In this video, I'm going to be talking you through how to photograph using a DSLR camera in manual mode. F number. The F is the aperture and it stands for the lens focal length. A bigger hole corresponds with a smaller F number and gives a brighter picture. It's the same way that the human eye works when its pupil dilates to let more light in under low levels of illumination. On an analog lens, we change the F numbers and we see the lens opening and closing. The numbers are called F stops. On a digital camera, these numbers are also called F stops, but are shown in thirds of a stop. Let's have a look at how depth of field works. I'm shooting the boat at an aperture of 5.6, focusing on the middle of the boat. I keep changing my aperture, closing it down, but I don't change the focus point. Notice how the focus area increases. This is the depth of field. Now comparing the two extremes, f5.6 versus f22. Here's a graph showing how the apertures are related to the depth of field. Unfortunately, in photography, we have an inverse relationship. The more open the aperture, the less depth of field we have. So in museum photography, we always aim at using F numbers above F8. There's much more about depth of field, but for now, I'd recommend always starting with F16. ISO. ISO in photography indicates the sensitivity of a digital camera sensor to light. Low ISO numbers ask for bright light conditions, but when we have low light conditions, high ISO numbers are best. However, for the purpose of museum photography, we aim at shooting at ISO 100, always. Let's have a look at why we should avoid using high ISO. By looking at this boat in more detail. Here we see a progression of images shot at different ISOs, increasing one stop at a time. Notice how the details of the boat become blurry, even though the image is always in focus. Comparing images taken with the 100 ISO versus 12,800 ISO, it's quite obvious why we should avoid high ISOs. Shutter speed. Shutter speed is the length of time the digital sensor is exposed to light. It is basically how long your camera spends taking a photo. It is measured in fractions of a second when they are under a second. For example, 1/4 means a quarter of a second. I'm using a mechanical camera here to show you what happens when the shutter is released. The numbers on a dial of a mechanical camera are fractions, even though they look like whole numbers. On digital cameras, these numbers can be shown as fractions or as wholes, depending on your model. Anything under 1/60th of a second is considered a low shutter speed, which means that images tend to be blurred if you are not using a tripod. Avoid any shutter speed that is below 1/60th of a second if you are hand-holding the camera. Shutter speed numbers are as follow. As the main purpose of these videos is to show you how to make the most of your equipment, I'd recommend setting up the shutter speed last, after you set up the ISO and the F number. For this to happen efficiently, you need to have the camera on a stable tripod, as most probably the shutter speed will be less than 30th of a second. Exposure. Now that we understand what the three main features of shooting in manual mean, the ISO, the shutter speed, and the F number, aperture, we can use them to calibrate the camera in order to take pictures with the right exposure. I'd recommend starting by setting up the camera at ISO 100, then set up the aperture at f16. In this case, the shutter speed is set at 60th of a second. If you press the shutter ever so slightly, trigger the light meter. Notice the vertical line that appears on the left-hand side of the scale under the number f16. At the moment, it is showing -2. This means that there is not enough light going through to take a well-exposed photograph. By changing the shutter speed, lowering down the shutter, so going for smaller numbers until I get to a whole second, the light meter scale starts to change. Notice that it only gets to zero when I reach the shutter speed of 3 seconds and 2 milliseconds. When I change to 4 seconds, the scale shows a light overexposure. As I'm shooting against a white background, I'd recommend using this light overexposure, which in fact is just the light meter compensating for the amount of whiteness around the object. It's not really overexposed. DSLRs allow you to check the exposure by using the histogram. Please read your camera manual to find it, as it varies model by model. By looking at the histogram, you can check the right exposure. A histogram is a graphical representation of exposure and tone values. Usually, a good histogram would render most tones in the middle portion of the graph, and no or few tones would be found at the extreme edges. Couple of tips. Shoot using a tripod. Use ISO 100. Set up your lens at minimum f11. Change the shutter speed to adjust the exposure. Take a picture to test your exposure. Look at the histogram to check if your exposure looks correct. And adjust the shutter speed if you need.